Okay, many of you are getting ready to cut out the mystery quilt, and it's got a lot of small strips and some squares. So I wanted to show you a tool that I use. Many of you may already use this, so just hit stop on the video. but I like it because it really saves a lot of time. If you notice that mystery quilt, you'll see that there's a whole list of directions on all different cuts. And you know, if you did it the old-fashioned way, yeah, that looks like a lot of work. But really, using one of these, it really goes pretty fast. This is a Shape Cut Plus by June Taylor. You can pick them up pretty much anywhere. Actually, I think even Walmart has them. I've seen them at Hobby Lobby, Michael's, Joann's, just about any of those places. I'm not sure about Joann. I'm not sure about Michael's. I have seen them at Hobby Lobby and Joann's, so, and Walmart. So you can pick them up anywhere. This is the 18-inch size. I like it because most of my fabrics, most of my pieces that I cut, I'm cutting with a 42-inch piece of fabric. You know, this is 42 inches, just folded once. And what I'll do is I will fold it again. And you can see my selvages, and my fold is up there and my selvage is there. And on that mystery quilt, there's quite a few 1.5-inch pieces. So what I'll do is I'll take my fabric, and I will, I don't know if you can see this here, but this is marked 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way down to 18, and it's got half-inch increments that's in between. I think the smaller one actually has quarter-inch increments, I'm not sure, but this has half-inch. And what I do first is I go ahead and cut off the first piece at the zero mark. And that just makes a nice clean edge for me to start off with. And what's nice about this is when I line this up, now when I go to line this up, if I press down on this part of the ruler, it sort of butts up. I don't know if you can see it, but it sort of butts up to that fabric and it won't go anywhere. If I've got it down, it really won't go anywhere. This is really helpful also when you have like 8 layers of fabric. Right now it's only 4. I check the horizontal line to make sure that it's even on the line, which it is, and it's even there. So I will just go for it. I'll just 1.5, 3, 4.5, 6, 7.5. Get where I'm going with that? You know, it took seconds to cut all these strips. Now, these are the 1.5-inch strips. Now, if I needed to, there's another one. If I needed to do that the old-fashioned way, this is what I would be doing, is I would have to turn my fabric, cut the raw edge, turn it, you know, measure this, cut it, pick it up, move it, cut it, pick it up. That's time consuming. I think that would take a lot more time than to just zip-zag. Okay, here we are again using the tool, and this time I'm going to use it to make blocks. I know in the mystery quilt we've got some 3.5-inch blocks, so I'm going to show you a quick way to do those with this tool. Here again I've got 42 inches of fabric. It's 4 layers right now. I've got it folded. And I'm going to start lining that up. I'm going to do my first cut. There's the first cut. Remember, if I put it down, if I kind of hold it to the cutting board, it won't go anywhere. So I'm going to start off doing 3.5. I'm going to do 2 rows of these. And then what I'm going to do is all I have to do is turn them. Oops, looks like my cutter didn't get it. I'm just going to turn them the other way and make sure that they're all butted up together, and that looks good. And I'm going to make another rough cut. Oops, let me turn it over so I can get the zero. Slide it over here so you can see what I'm doing. Okay, I'm going to make another rough cut. There we go. And I'm going to go 3.5, 7. 8, 9, 10, it would be 10.5. Oh yeah, I can get one more out of there. You didn't see me count on my fingers. Okay, and there we've got, there's 8, 16, there's 24. Real fast, that was within seconds too. Now, on some of them, I have you cut 3 7/8 or 4 3/8 and stuff like that. Still, when I do that, I just round up to the next half and cut my blocks, and then I'll take another ruler and trim them out. But it just makes it real manageable because then I've already got part of the square cut. So when I go to trim them out to 3/8 or whatever. I just have to do it up and down. I mean, up and across.